Asthma is the most common chronic condition affecting pregnant women in Australia. 1 in 10 pregnancies are affected by asthma. Although the safety of preventive medications, including inhaled corticosteroids for use in pregnancy, has been established, many women discontinue using these medicines during pregnancy because of safety concerns. Poorly controlled asthma during pregnancy has been shown to be associated with increased risk of preterm birth and low birth weight. The Center for Medicine Use and Safety has been focusing on interventions for promoting self-management of asthma and improving health outcomes. With the increasing use of smart mobile phones, our focus has been on the use of mobile phone apps for promoting self-management of asthma.
Participants were issued with a COPD6 to measure their lung function daily, and a specially designed Breathe Easy application installed on a lone smartphone to record asthma symptoms and asthma medication usage weekly. All data were transmitted automatically to a central server to which the researchers, participants, and their health professionals had secure access. Participants' health professionals were contacted by a trained asthma professional if any medication changes or unscheduled asthma-related visits were needed.
We conducted a single-blind randomized controlled trial in which the outcome assessor was masked to the treatment allocation at follow-up visits. This figure shows the primary endpoint of the trial, changes in asthma control questionnaire scores. The control group is indicated in red and the intervention group in blue. A higher score means worse asthma control. You can see that the groups were quite well matched at baseline. After 3 months follow-up, there was a small but not statistically significant difference. However, after 6 months follow-up, the intervention group had significantly better asthma control. The next figure shows changes in the mini asthma quality of life score. Here, a higher score means a better quality of life. The groups were well matched at baseline. There was a small but non-significant difference at 3 months. However, after 6 months follow-up, the intervention group had statistically significantly better quality of life.
Our study has shown that telehealth interventions supporting self-management is feasible and could potentially improve asthma control and asthma-related quality of life during pregnancy.